Okay, you've decided to buy your first telescope. Well, congratulations. You're embarking on a fascinating hobby that can last you a lifetime. If you've already started looking, you'll have quickly realized that choosing the right instrument is not easy. There are so many choices. Let's cut through the clutter together so you can choose the right telescope for you. To get started, let's go over the different designs you'll encounter in today's marketplace. Refractors are what most of us think of as the classic telescope. This design uses a multi-element lens at the front to form the image. The big advantage is its simplicity. The tube is sealed, so they're easy to keep clean and require little to no maintenance. The optical alignment is locked in at the factory, so you'll never have to worry about it. These scopes are generally available in smaller sizes that are easy to set up and use. If you're looking for a grab-and-go scope, or just something for casual viewing, a good refractor is hard to beat. The downside is that refractors become very heavy and expensive in apertures much over 4 inches. They deliver outstanding images, but the smaller aperture will limit performance on faint objects like nebula and galaxies. The next type to look at are the compound telescopes. These designs go by names like ketadioptric and maksutov. These systems use a combination of lenses and mirrors to form the image. Like the refractor, ketadioptrics have sealed tubes and seldom, if ever, need alignment or internal cleaning. Unlike refractors, they're available in larger apertures at reasonable prices. They also have very short tube lengths, which make them easy to mount and transport. By far the most common type of telescope in use today, they offer a good balance of size, simplicity, and performance that's hard to beat. There's also a wide variety of aftermarket accessories available for the type, so it's easy to get into things like photography and other specialized areas of interest. The last kind of telescope we'll be looking at are the reflectors. This design uses a large and small mirror to form the image. If you're looking for as much aperture as you can get, this will be the way to go. If you have good skies and are interested in faint objects, a large reflector would be a good choice. However, it will require more TLC than any other type for it to perform well. The tube is open, so the optics will need to be cleaned and eventually recoated. They're also sensitive to vibration and handling, which results in misalignment of the optics. Correcting this condition is the first thing any owner of a reflector will learn to do. All that said, if you're willing to live with the care and upkeep, a large reflector can give you views that no smaller scope can. The last thing to consider is how the instrument is mounted. The sky is constantly in motion. To compensate for it and present a steady image to the observer, you'll need a tracking or equatorial mount. Most telescopes include the mount, including the drive motor for tracking. The exception would be the large Dobsonian reflectors. These feature a simple push-and-go mount that will take a little getting used to and are for visual use only. It's also worth noting that computer-controlled mounts are available for many scopes and have become very popular. These systems have the ability to take you to any object automatically, which can be a great plus if you really don't know your way around the sky yet. One last thought to keep in mind is that the best telescope for you is the one that gets used. Sure, a large telescope will show more than a small one, but if it's too heavy or complicated to set up, you'll simply not use it very often. If you're reasonable about your expectations and abilities, you'll make the right choice, igniting a love and interest in astronomy that will last a lifetime.